In this video, we'll try to understand what exactly are async and await keywords in .NET. Now, both async and await keywords are new features, you know, which have been introduced in .NET 4.5 framework. So let me give a one-liner description of what async and await commands are. Async and await are nothing but their markers. They are markers, you know, which mark code positions from where the control should resume after a task or a thread completes. Let me repeat what I have said. Async and await are nothing but their code markers which mark code positions from where control should resume after a task or a thread completes. Now, let me make you understand this description what I have said in a more better manner, or I'll say in a more practical manner. So you can see that I have a very simple code here, which is nothing but it's a very simple console application. And this console application, what it does is it has this static void main. The static void main invokes a method, and this method actually invokes a long task method in a asynchronous mode, or I'll say rather in a parallel mode. Okay, and this long task method actually waits for 20 seconds. So you can see that I have put a thread.sleep here, and this thread.sleep actually happens for 20 seconds. It is 20,000 milliseconds, which is equivalent to 20 seconds. Now, what is the problem with this code? So what I'll do is I'm going to go and put a debug point here very quickly, and I'm going to go and run this application in a debug mode. Okay, so let me go and start this debugging. So let me press F11. So there it is. Now, from static void main, this method is invoked here, and from this line I'm invoking this long task in a multi-threaded way, or I'll say in a parallel way. So I'm using this task parallel library here. In case you are new to task parallel library, what my suggestion would be to go and see the threading questions and answers video series from quest1video.com, where I explained what is TPL, you know, what advantages does TPL have, and how it is different from threading. Okay, so I will refrain from talking about TPL here. In case you are interested, please go and see those videos, you know, which are like 30 to 40 minutes of videos. I'm sure that you will understand TPL in a better manner. Okay, so in this video, we'll just restrict ourselves to async and await keywords. Now, from this line, from this code, I'll say, if I do a F11, you can see that the debug point has just gone ahead to this console.writeline new thread. This long task is invoked in a multi-threaded way, but you know, the line just went ahead, or I'll say the code just went ahead, and he started executing console.writeline new thread. Now, what I want here is, I want that, you know, this code or this line should run after this 20 seconds has finished executing. So I want that at this position, this code should actually wait until this long task finishes. So how do we go about achieving that? So one way is you go write lengthy codes, you know, where you say, okay, thread.wait, and then say thread.sleep. And then you again, you know, write those synchronization logic between method and long task. So that is one way of doing it. Or the other way is use the new easy .NET 4.5 feature, async and await. So what you can do here is you can say that the control should wait here. So you can see that I'm putting a code marker here. As I've said, async and await are nothing but their code markers. So I'm saying here, wait at this line until this long task finishes. And wherever you write this await keyword, you need to ensure that that method is marked by the async keyword. So async and await are, you know, keywords, you know, which you have to use in pair. In other words, you know, you cannot use await without async. You cannot use async without await. So at this point, I'm saying, please wait here until this long task finishes. And because I have used a await keyword inside this method, I need to mark this method as async. Now see what happens. Now, so if I now go ahead and if I say debug, so let me say F11 here, so there it goes. Now you can see from this point onwards, you know, this line, this code of line will go in a wait mode. So now if I do a F11, so if I just put a debug point to the just to the next line of code here, so even if I put a debug point here, and even if I do F11, you can see this line of code has gone in a wait mode. So until this long task finishes this 20 second time, this console.writeline new thread will not be executed. And once, you know, the 20 second time finishes, you know, then this line of code will execute. So you will see after 20 seconds, there it is. You can see now the console.write line is now getting executed. So in other words, async and await are nothing but their code markers, which says that from which position onwards the code should continue after, you know, you invoke a method or a function in a multi-threaded or in a parallel way. So now if I do F11, so there it is. So you can see the main thread went ahead, he was released, okay, but the new thread, this guy, you know, this console.write line, you know, actually got executed, you know, after the long task finished executing. So the main thread was released, guys, you know. So I just wanted to make sure that, you know, everybody is getting the point. The main thread did not wait. The main thread went ahead and executed console.write line main thread, but this method, you know, went in a halt mode until this await finishes over here. So that was a very simple demonstration of what exactly is the use of async and await command in .NET 4.5. So I hope that you enjoyed this video. In this video, we were trying to understand what is the use of async and await commands in .NET. Thank you so much.